My name is Sam from Creative Minds. In this video, we'll be discussing two add-ons to the CM Tooltip Glossary plugin. The first add-on we'll be discussing is called the CM Tooltip Glossary Skins, and this allows you to change the theme and look of your tooltip. The second add-on we'll be discussing is called the Glossary Login Statistics, and this allows you to track how users are interacting with the tooltip on your WordPress site. So let's get started. The first step in this process is installing the add-on. So you can do this through your dashboard. You're going to go to Plugins, then Installed Plugins. Next, you're going to search for the add-on. Then you'll need to activate it. Next, you're going to need to input your license key. So you can go to your tooltip and click on License. Next, you'll need to put in your license key here and activate that license.
So after you've installed the add-on and you've input your license key, you can start playing around with the Skins add-on. You can go to the settings through your CM tooltip. So you're going to click on Settings, and then you'll click on the Tooltip Skins tab here. So at the bottom of this page is a preview of what the changes that you make are going to look like on your tooltip. You can choose from among an array of default tooltip templates, such as Alert, which makes the tooltip appear in a bright, eye-catching red. Or what's super cool about this particular add-on is that you're really able to customize every single element of the tooltip, from where it appears when you hover over a term, to the stem length and the width of the stem, to really where that text is fitting into the tooltip itself. You can also choose different background colors, and you can also change the opacity of the background as well. So you can make it more or less transparent, and you can change the opacity of the content. You can choose from any different border color. A border radius, this is just how rounded the edges of the tooltip are going to appear, from completely square to a very rounded edge. So depending on the style that you're really looking for, you can use the skins to really customize and personalize what your tooltip looks like. The border width is pretty self-explanatory. It's how wide that line is going to appear around the tooltip. You can choose from a dashed, dotted, or solid line. Font color, so this is what color the text is going to appear, so you could have it be white. And you can also have the title either match or be different from the text below it. You can adjust the title size, and you can also adjust the font size. Again, you can customize the font. There's a few options here. And again, at any point, you can refresh this preview down here to see what your tooltip looks like, considering the changes you've made. So now let's talk about the Log and Statistics add-on. After you've activated it and put in your license key, you can access it through your tooltip glossary. And here you're going to click on Logs. So what this does for you is it provides you with statistics of every single instance that someone has interacted with the tooltip or the glossary on your site. It organizes the statistics by type of event. So I'm going to give you an example of each one of these events: term clicked, related clicked, link in tooltip clicked, and tooltip displayed. Tooltip displayed is when someone hovers over the term and the tooltip appears next to it. Term clicked is when someone actually chooses to click on that term, in addition to hovering over it. Related article clicked is when someone visits the widget at the end of a poster page that contains all of the glossary terms that appear in that page, and they choose to click on one of those terms. Link in tooltip clicked is when someone hovers over a term and then clicks on a link within the tooltip. One really, really cool thing about this is that you can access this information either in a list or in a graphic form. You can filter by a period of time or type of event. So for example, we're showing this month all event types, or we can just show when a term was clicked. So you can visualize and track periods of heightened traffic on your site. What's also particularly useful is the logs table. And when you're looking at the table, you can filter by event type or by time. So when we're looking at by event type, this shows the term name and how many times it was hovered, how many times someone clicked on the term, and then after clicking on the term, they went through to that related article or that related term. You can also filter by time for the logs table. And this is going to give you a list that you can again filter by period of time. It'll tell you the event type, exactly what time this event occurred, the URL for the link clicked. If someone is logged into the site, it will show you their username. And if they're not logged into the site, they show up as anonymous. And there's also a geographic locator, so you can see the country of the user. You can also download these statistics to Excel for further analysis. So to conclude this video, I just want to talk a little bit about how the login statistics add-on can really increase the functionality of your site and be a very powerful tool. Whether you have a technical site or you're using the tooltip as a content marketing strategy or you have a language site, in all of these cases, the login statistics add-on lets you see which terms are interesting to people, which terms are popular, where you need to put more emphasis, how many times people are actually hovering, clicking, and really interacting with that particular term in your glossary. And I encourage all of you to check it out. Visit tooltip.cminds.com to explore and purchase the Tooltip Glossary plugin. Also be sure to check out and subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/cminds channel.